to another edition of Season 21 of RGV Stars, live with Alex Arabia and Isaac Medina. Remember, RGV Stars is
the premier platform for showcasing Rio Grande Valley talent
and the RGV celebrities' place to be. Celebrities and community leaders like Gilberto Falcon, attorney and the new mayor of Rio Grande City. Thank you for being here with us on RGV Stars.
Well, thank you so much for having me here tonight. I appreciate the invite.
Awesome. And tonight, our viewers will have the opportunity to get to know more about you, your career, your background, achievements, obstacles, future goals, and anything else that you want to share, including future goals for the city.
Absolutely.
Rio Grande. Sounds good.
All right, Mayor Falcon, super excited to have you here. So tell us what got you started and why did you want to become mayor? What did you study before? What were you doing before you became mayor?
Well, for all of those that don't know me, my name is Gilberto Falcon, and I am originally from Mexico. I moved to Roma when I was about 11 years old. And then after that, I graduated high school. After graduating high school, I got a summer job with one of our local attorneys, who is Calixto Villarreal. Definitely one of my role models, by the way. So I was with him for about a year, and then that's when I made the decision that I like what I saw in his practice, what he had to offer, and I decided to, with his encouragement, decided to become a lawyer myself. I could see that there was a lot of potential when it came to a lawyer in order to help some other people when they need somebody the most. That got me started with my career. And if we fast forward, I've been able to help a lot of clients, a lot of families throughout my career. And when it came to politics,
there How many years as an attorney? I'm sorry? How many years as an attorney?
I've been an attorney since 2008.
Okay.
So that's close to 16 years that
16
I've been practicing.
Years.
Yes. And so I saw that through my practice, I could help a lot of people, that I could be a service to a lot of different families. And that's where I saw an opportunity as a mayor to help our community.
Wow.
And you've been mayor now for how many months?
Well, the election was in May.
Okay.
And ever since May, I've been the mayor of Rio Grande City.
And how has the experience been in these few months for you so far?
Well, obviously, this is a new experience for me. And it takes a transitional period. There's a learning curve as well as to what are the requirements for being the mayor of Rio Grande. And I think that for the first couple of months and even up to right now, it's getting up to speed with everything that's going on with the city, because there's a lot of work, there's a lot of interconnected things that are happening. So obviously you first have to get familiar with all of those things. But so far we're doing good. I'm very enthusiastic about the new position.
Is it hard balancing everything, like your job as an attorney, being a mayor, and then family life and everything else that you do?
I would say it is. Obviously, there's a lot of expectations from the community as the mayor, right? You're technically and essentially the face of the city. You're the representative. And with that, it comes a lot of responsibility, not only in the leadership of the city, but also in and also representing the city as well, right? Because you have to attend all of these various events on behalf of the city. And on top of that, you have to do the leadership part of the city as well. So
and I know there's many new businesses in Rio as of
right.
late, many more to come. Can you tell us a little bit about how you see the future, your vision for Rio in the next 5 to 10 years?
Absolutely. Well, Rio Grande City, I think it's a place that's growing dramatically right now. There's a lot of investors that have their eye in Rio Grande City. They see the potential, so they're coming in with new ideas, new business propositions, and they really want to invest their dollars in Rio Grande because they see the potential. So right now there's several projects that are in the works, a lot of retail development. Obviously, the old administration had started several projects. And as we come in, those projects, they took a lot of work, and we need to finalize a lot of those projects as well. So we see that there's going to be a lot of new commercial developments, but not only that, I don't know if you heard, but the port of entry, the Star Camargo Bridge, is going to expand itself. So with that, that brings a lot of commercial traffic. So we're getting ready for that as well. We're inviting, obviously, the industrial sector to Rio Grande City. There's going to be a need to service a lot of those commercial transportations, as well as cold storage and storage, dry storages and things like that. So to us as a community, that translates into employment, obviously careers, development, and a lot of potential for our citizens.
And I know that recently you opened a state-of-the-art new police and fire department, right?
Yes. Rio Grande City, if you're familiar with the city, obviously our police department was stationed at a historical building. Our fire department was stationed at a different location. And even within the departments, they were kind of like scattered all
and
over
the
place.
Not a lot of space for them.
And
either.
Definitely not a lot of space. So the city obviously needed a different place where they could perform all of this civil duties. And the public safety building has been one of the greatest buildings that has ever been built in Rio Grande. We just had the grand opening. It's a state-of-the-art building. It's obviously it's going to house our police department and our fire department as well. And it's equipped with all of the newest technology that you can think of. So we're very proud of
that. Plenty of space, very spacious.
And the space is obviously there, and we have a lot of acreage behind the building as well if we need to develop or add to the building.
Yeah. So. And I know more DHR services are coming right to Rio, more buildings and services.
That's correct. That's on the west side of Rio Grande. There's going to be currently there is a very big development that's being sponsored by DHR. It's going to have a lot of specialty clinics. And I think that it also, it's going to house a program for a residency program for students that want to obviously become doctors in the future.
So many more opportunities for students.
So.
And on the commercial side, on the retail, many stores, many new restaurants. I know an IHOP is on its way, right?
IHOP is being built right now as we speak. We're very proud of that development. We're also trying to invite new restaurants as well, some other retail stores, and ultimately...
What are some of the ones that you would like personally to have in Rio, in your ideal dream?
Well, in talking to there have been talks about an Olive Garden, one of them, right, that some of the investors were interested. They have not made any commitments to build, but obviously it brings a different set of food to Rio Grande, right?
Definitely.
So, and I think that if we could have one other ideal restaurant, I think that another steakhouse would be a great addition to Rio Grande. I think that would complete that phase, and then obviously we have the retail on the back.
Excellent. What are some of the things that you'd like to achieve during your term in Rio Grande City?
One of the things that we want to bring is that conscience to Rio Grande, and I mean about the public, right? There's a lot of young population that has a tendency to leave our town, right? And they're chasing better opportunities, job opportunities and things like that. And that's one of the things that we want to retain. We want to retain all of our youth there. And the only way that we can do that is if we focus on employment, careers, that our property taxes are fairly priced, so that we can make it an environment suitable for anybody that wants to stay there and call Rio Grande City their home. So that's one of our primary focuses on in development in Rio Grande.
Awesome. That's a great thing. But what do you think is your biggest achievement and also your biggest obstacle in your professional career?
Okay. And when you're talking about that, are we talking about my career as a lawyer or as a mayor?
Let's do both.
Overall.
Well, I think that I already talked about some of the goals that we have for the city, right? Mm-hmm. Our focus is to retain the families together and that they can call Rio Grande City their home and stay there. And obviously, for those that don't know, I'm a lawyer, and all I do is personal injury. It's a difficult practice because you have to address the needs of those individuals that have been involved in some kind of catastrophic injury, something that happened to them, right? And we're there to assist them. So 5 to 10 years, I would like to grow my firm. I would like to have maybe another 2 or 3 attorneys that can join our firm and help us litigate, because like I said, we always have a purpose. We always have a vision of trying to help those in need, right? And that's why I think that my career, along with being the mayor of Rio Grande, goes hand in hand, because we provide a service, we try to help families, we try to help our community, and I'm strictly committed to that at this very point of my career.
Awesome.
And how important has the family support been in your life? Because I know having a busy schedule, your family must be understanding and supportive, right?
Well, every achievement that I've been able to have and as in my professional career, I would have not been able to do that without my family. And by that, I mean my wife, my friends, my parents, and mostly my wife. She has always been my backbone. She has always been there for me. She has always been very supportive.
And you can say hi to her. I'm sure she'll be watching dinner. Mm-hmm.
Yes, she's been very supportive throughout my whole career. And she has been my biggest cheerleader, my biggest supporter, right? And besides her, yeah, my entire family, my friends, all of those individuals that supported me throughout my career, my role model, Calixto Villarreal, along with some of the
local... iconic attorney in Rio Grande City.
Absolutely, yes. Along with some other judges, local judges there that have been an inspiration to me. But you got to recognize that when you achieve something, okay, sometimes you might be the face, but it takes a whole team of people to be able to achieve that. And for that, I'm very grateful for all the friends that I have, for my family, for my wife, for everybody that's been there to help us, because it's very difficult. And a lot of times, like I said, you don't see the work that's being done behind the scenes. And a lot of those people deserve a lot of credit, because without them, you wouldn't be able to achieve the things
that we do. Very true. And where do you see yourself in the future? Personal goals in the next 5 to 10 years for you?
Well, like I said, in terms of being an attorney, I would like to grow my firm. I would like to be able to house another 2 or 3 attorneys that can assist so that we can provide a much better service to the community.
That's nice. Yes. And a closing remark, a closing message for the fans, the viewers of RGV Stars?
Absolutely. Well, I would like to say that all of those individuals that have been or that have been part of my career, that have been there to support me, I would like to say thank you so much. To all of those individuals that showed up to our campaign, I want to say thank you. I can't stress that enough, because it's very important that all the work that we do collectively, it's a reflection of Rio Grande, and I want for Rio Grande to be one of the greatest cities where you can call home, and that you know that you're going to be able to raise your family there.
Well, thank you so much. We wish you the best. More success and more blessings.
Thank you so much.
In your future.
It's a pleasure to have you here, Mayor.
Thank you so much.
And this was another edition of Season 21 of RGV Stars, live with Alex Arabia and Isaac Medina. Remember, RGV Stars is...
the premier platform for showcasing Rio Grande Valley talent.
And the RGV Celebrities Place to Be. Until next time.
See you guys.
Thank you so much.